$13.1 million was what it cost last year to keep the defensive end on the roster for one more season. But Pierre Paul, he didn't chew up for that. He had a good season in 2011, a great season in 2011. Got back to 12 and a half sacks in his contract year, 2012, 2013. And it was driven by back problems, but still, he's getting older now. Probably all. And how can you trust the guy on the wall to deal with big money? Maybe one of the reasons he had 12 and a half sacks last year is because he was chasing the contract. Haven't we seen guys who find the gas pedal in their contract years, get big money, and then back it off completely? I'd be concerned about that with JPP from a franchise tag standpoint. $13.1 million, too much. Huge contract, too much. Something reasonable, fine. If that means someone else is going to sign and overpay them because they want to make their team better, they want to make the press conference, they want to hold up the jersey, let them pay. Find somebody else. Don't overpay a long-term deal for a guy that may not be like the guy that was suffering from 2011 any longer. One of the reasons JPP may not be playing as well as he was in 2011 is the interior defensive line. They need to upgrade the interior significantly. They could have taken Aaron Donald last year. People thought they were going to take Aaron Donald. It worked out better for them taking over and leaving Aaron Donald on the board. Didn't work out well for the Lions leaving Aaron Donald on the board and taking Aaron Donald. They will get the Giants a pass for selecting Odell Beckham Jr., but still, got to think about improving and upgrading the interior defensive line. That makes it so much easier to get a pass rush on the outside when you have guys creating havoc on the inside and commanding extra attention. Offensive side of the ball, look at every position. Think about the year of the Giants won Super Bowls, got to the postseason, seven. Strong offensive line. The offensive line has dipped, and as a result, the team's overall performance has dipped. Not a coincidence. However, John Brown has already said they need to upgrade the offensive line. 28 sacks last year for Eli Manning. Manning not playing as well as he could or should. One of the big reasons. The offensive line. And then finally, I'm just worried about that. Great kid. We had him on set on PFTN and CSN with the Super Bowl. Very engaging. Seems humble a bit after what he's gone through this year, but the challenge is going to be to keep him humble. There was a time when maybe Victor Cruz allowed himself to get too swept up in the whole sense of playing as a celebrity. He wasn't even back. Beckham came in as a first-round draft choice, missed the first four games of the season due to a hamstring injury, and then just exploded. One of the great catches of all time. Plenty of attention, plenty of off-field opportunities, plenty of hype, plenty of buzz. Don't let him lose sight of the things he needs to do to continue to be a successful NFL receiver and to continue to grow and develop. So if you have him playing at a high level, and Cruz healthy after that ruptured patellar tendon playing at a high level, this Giants team really could get back to the playoffs. And we know when they get there, it's hard to beat them. And they often end up holding a silver trophy. Okay, over the Rams, who have yet to get their fingers on that trophy since the greatest show on the turf, which was fueled by Kurt Warner. This edition of the Rams, fueled by who knows. You get the feeling that they're ready to move on to the same draft. Yeah, they want to compete to be the starter, ready to handle the job. They wanted to restructure his contract in the last year of the final number one overall big money contract that was paid out to a quarterback. You got to figure out who the quarterback's going to be. Bradford, Sean Miller, someone else, that's going to be the top issue. Then, probably take Greg Robinson, number two overall pick last year, slide it out to the left side, left tackle, and maybe time to move on from Jake Long. Too many injuries in 9.25 minutes due to Jake Long, and 15 by law. Hello to Robinson, 10.9 tackle. Kenny Britt did very well last year in his only season with the Rams. Find a way to keep around, not the franchise tag. Find a way to keep around. However, you have to without being ridiculously lavish in your expenditures, because who else is really going to come out? But he's turned himself around well in St. Louis, and I think it's in his interest to stay. Next up on the list, find some veterans who are hungry and who can move. Because I feel like this is mainly a young team. It needs more people like James Laurinaitis, more people like Chris Horn, more veteran voices who can provide real leadership to get the team to play every week like they play against the Seahawks, the Cardinals, and the 49ers. If they have that kind of focus every week, James Laurinaitis scores that during the season. When they have these big games, the players are on their focus. They're going to be able to do it. consistencies, and that kind of leads to the fifth point, the confidence. Strive for consistency, week in and week out, game in and game out. This team is good enough to beat anyone in the NFL, but they're not good enough to beat everyone. Because for every game of the Seahawks or 49ers or the Cardinals, they find a way to step the top and lose a game in ugly fashion that they could have or should have won. This team needs that consistency and match. Maybe it's the commencement of its attachment to the fan base in St. Louis, the team's going to move. Who knows? Maybe it's the lack of better leaders. Either way, this team needs to find a way week in and week out to be as good as it is when it's facing one of its arch rivals from the NFC West. We're going to flip it over to the AFC in return. Talk to Jerry Hughes, Buffalo Bills defensive end, about to become a free agent. Unless he doesn't, that's the best sign. Effort